effects of the oil spill in the Gulf of Mexico are being felt in Louisiana, where one public beach is closed this morning because of thick globs of oil that have washed ashore. Let's take a live look at the underwater feed being provided by BP, showing that spewing oil right now on the Gulf floor. That's actually not, I don't know if that's not exactly what we're looking at there, or maybe something cloudy in the water. Yeah, you see a little bit of it there. Meantime, there's another delay in BP's latest attempt to stop all of that gushing oil. NBC's Jay Gray is live in Venice, Louisiana this morning. So Jay, good morning. What are you hearing about this latest delay to try to contain the oil leak? Because wasn't it set for tomorrow?
Yeah, it was supposed to start, and good morning to you, Alex. Not good news here along the coast. It was supposed to start late Sunday, and now we're being told by BP engineers that they're just simply not ready. They've never done this before. The depth is unbelievable, 5,000 feet at the floor of the Gulf there, and the magnitude of the spill is one they've never really had to deal with, so they just say we're not ready. There are also some indications that perhaps this is a one-shot deal. If this top kill, as they go in, if it doesn't work, they may damage more the wellhead down there and make it even tougher to seal off. So they want to make sure they have everything prepared, getting things in place, both on the floor of the Gulf and with the process on top, and making sure that everything is in proper order before they go in and try and seal this well. Again, it's a gamble. Like we're saying, they've never done this before. They admit that it's not a guarantee, and they say we've got other things we're working on in case this doesn't work. What they will do initially if the top kill process doesn't work is that they will move the top hat containment dome, which has been on the floor of the Gulf for a couple of weeks now. They'll move it over the spill to try and capture more of the oil coming out. Right now, BP says with the insertion tube, they're collecting about 2,200 barrels a day. But as you watch that video, you realize a lot more is going into the Gulf.
Yeah, and the beach closed up there because of all the oil globs. I mean, yep. Do you have an idea of how prevalent those globs are?
They're getting worse, according to officials on Grand Isle, which is just south of New Orleans. They say that more oil is moving in. They've closed the beaches to clean it up. Obviously, don't feel it's safe. They see the sheen with every wave that whips up against the sands there, but they say now they're beginning to see some darker oil. And that's the fear, that this thicker, darker oil is moving closer to the coastline, Alex. It's a bad situation. It's getting worse, and they still can't stop the leak.
Yeah. Okay, Jay Gray, thank you very much for that. So with this disaster growing by the day, there are new details this morning on the government's response to the Gulf Coast oil spill. In his weekly address, the president announced the creation of a bipartisan commission to investigate the cause of the spill and its effects. The seven-member panel will be co-chaired by former Senator Bob Graham and former EPA Administrator William Riley. The commission will issue a report within 6 months of its first meeting.